I'm Brittany, this is Alice, and welcome to Gaywatch, where we watch gay things. Today is episode one of Cowboy Bebop. Surprise? I always planned on watching this show, just because I never got around to watching the anime, and I heard that a live-action version of a classic anime was good, and that alone warrants attention. But then someone came into my ask box on Tumblr and said, did you know that there's canon gayness in this show? And I said, absolutely not. And also now I have to react to it in some way, shape, or form. This was not on the schedule. This has come clear out of nowhere. And as a result, since this is a bonus series of sorts for this channel, I'm going to look at the numbers of what it does when this episode lands on YouTube and see exactly how much people want to watch more. And it will really depend on that as to whether or not I react to all the episodes on YouTube. And if it doesn't do that well, that's fine. I can just finish the series on Patreon and it'll be made public eventually, kind of as per usual. So if you like this video and you want to see me react to the entire season on YouTube, please like, comment, subscribe, share, all that jazz. It is the only way I can tell that you guys want things. Anyway, I have no idea what I'm about to get into, except I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a really good time. From what little I know about the anime, I'm kind of curious to see John Cho in a role like this. Like, I love him, obviously. He wouldn't have been the first name that pops into mind. And of course, I say this with very, very, very little information as to the series itself. So maybe I'm entirely wrong and he was like dead ass perfect. And I don't know when exactly the queer stuff starts happening. Don't tell me. Just in general, don't tell me anything. We're very anti-spoiler around here, but we are very nice about it. But I'll hit play on episode one of Cowboy Bebop and find out for myself. I'm so curious. I'm just so curious. I did not expect this to be on my queer bingo card for 2021, but here we are, and here we go.
They control everything now.
Okay, we're already flexing with the cinematography.
Medicine, and then he got fired because what's the use of a one-eyed pit boss, am I right, Carol?
This is the most Tarantino opening I have seen in a long ass time. Yes! I live for character entrances!
Yeah.
The hell you think?
I came here to place a bet.
Oh no. Oh no! Okay, there's camera movement in this show. This is way too much fun. What the fuck?
Drop the guns!
I'd say no. Yeah. No, babe, you're not. You're the opening villain.
Spike.
I mean, you got kids, right? You ready to go?
I have never seen John Cho like this. Oh!
Jesus Christ, is it all gonna be sensible, right? Right, Spike?
I don't think this man has been sensible a day in his life. Ooh! It's a good gun! That's a very good gun. If a show like this didn't have queerness in it somewhere, that would have been just an injustice. You can't have this much fun and no gayness, you know what I mean? Oh, there he goes.
Where is it?
Probably not in the casino. Okay, maybe it is. What do I know about this fictional universe? This poor woman, can she go home?
Just a humble bounty hunter, ma'am.
Excellent. Perfect. Okay. If anybody knows anything, it's at least It's at least pieces of the opening of Cowboy Bebop. Like, who doesn't know that? I love me a show with some style, you know? Some flair. Some fun. Just, we are here to have fun. Oh, this is backstory, isn't it? Oh, no. That was hot. Oh my god, the Firefly vibes. I know that couch. Everything's going to be fine. Trust me. Oh, it's all gonna go to shit now. Can't say stuff like that in a show like this. Not gonna lie, Asimov, that's kind of terrifying.
Hey, buddy.
Is that I clocked that in the background.
One that walks with a limp?
That's why you were throwing her your own bone, I bet.
I was gonna go there. It has kind of a low budget feel. But I think that was deliberate. Outside of the sci-fi shots, the space shots are like top tier. Hang on. Pause. I'm looking disrespectfully. Don't they get a bigger crew? I know it's not just them. I think there's at least a girl. Gonna help a pregnant lady smoke?
It's bad for your health, I hear.
Daddy, I love him.
Heard that too.
Rough trade being a romantic.
Fucking tell me about it.
Is that shit working all the girls?
Who are you? Oh. Oh. God, that could disembowel a guy real quick. The sets! They're so big and so beautiful. Oh, give me this moment. You give me that saxophone. And you give me this moment! Yes!
Okay, who is she?
She's a bounty hunter.
Please tell me she's a new crew member.
When it comes to the syndicate, we walk away. Right?
Suddenly you give a shit about the rules.
I was just about to say! Can I just say... Her bi vibes are immaculate, pristine, cannot be touched. An actual explosion? An actual, it's not CG, it's an actual fire. Fucking joking! Oh yeah, babe, I think you were projecting your tragic backstory onto the desperate chick of this episode. Can I write a love letter to this director of photography, please? Oh, sweetie. No. No, you're not. Yeah, you take a second to grieve. That was a fine ass man. Her dad must be fucking awful. It's so interesting to me how Spike's backstory makes him have a soft spot for wanting to help women because of the favorite woman that he couldn't help. Which, may not be the most original thing in the world, but... It's the way that they're doing it. It's such a sensitive romantic way. I don't know, I really appreciate it. I really like it. That's a lot of dead fish.
Dead tears of Scott.
What was that, Viserys?
Felix is dead. Right?
The crossover I'm having with the Taylor Swift fandom right now.
Bring me.
Okay, Samurai Lucius. Oh, come on. Oh. Classic. Classic. Stop. Stop having so much fun. I am in. I'm so in. I'd be in if, you know, queer representation never showed up in this show. But apparently at some point it does. So I'm double in, triple in even. But I would be down even if this was just your regular mainstream straight show. It's just too much fucking fun. It is illegal how much fun this is. And I swear to God, I know this sounds like super specific or it might be like weird, but the real fire has me so happy. Because I'm so tired of overuse of CG, as is everybody else to a certain extent. But specifically with stuff like that, where a real fire would look so much better than anything you can currently do with CG. And yet, 9 times out of 10, kind of more like 10 times out of 10 these days, they'll just use it with CG anyway, and it will look awful. And in a couple of years, it will look even worse. But they used real fucking fire. And now that scene is timeless. Thank you. Just thank you. Thank you so much. An excellent first episode to what could very easily shape up to be one of my favorite shows of this year. What a delightful fucking surprise. Something live action based on anime that isn't shit. Thank you. I feel like there's so much potential in adapting anime into live action shows that is just gone unused or misused. And like, thank you. Thank you. This is what I mean. You can get great live action adaptations out of anime if you fucking do it right. That's it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz to tell me if you would like for me to finish this entire series on YouTube. That's the only way I can tell what you guys want to see on here. So if you would like for this to keep going, please let me know. And I'll be back in some way, shape, or form. Maybe on YouTube, maybe on Patreon. But I am going to finish this series. Absolutely. It's fantastic. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and please remember to take care of yourself.